beautiful day. Days may come and days may go. Some bring rain and some bring snow. Some bring laughter, some bring tears. They turn to weeks, then months, then years. Some bring birthdays, presents and smiles. On some we travel miles and miles to holiday places in the sun. Where there is sea and sand and fun, there are the times when you just want to say, oh, what a wonderful, wonderful day.
Some days it's better to stay in bed. California gets a lot of forest fires, and the one in 1998 wasn't a very big one. However, it was near some houses, so the firefighters went to control it quickly. Fortunately, by the end of the day, the fire was out and the houses weren't damaged. It was just one of the hundreds of forest fires that the California Fire Service has to fight every year. There was nothing unusual about it, but a few days later, the fire inspectors found something very unusual indeed. While inspecting the damage to the forest, they found a body. A walker, perhaps, who got trapped by the fire? No, this was definitely not a walker. It was a scuba diver. The man was wearing a full scuba diving outfit, a wetsuit with a mask on his face, flippers on his feet, and oxygen tanks on his back. Who was he? The man wasn't carrying a wallet or anything to identify him. The fire inspectors called in the police. They checked the dental records of all the people who have disappeared on the day of the fire, and they soon identified the man. The biggest mystery remained. What was a scuba diver doing in the middle of a forest 30 kilometers away from the ocean? They found that he was on his holiday and he was scuba diving. A helicopter with a water tank was bringing water from the sea. He picked up a scuba diver with water and poured it into the forest.
Susan's story. Well, it's really rather a strange story and a bit sad. Recently, my dog died. My dog Churchill. I was very fond of Churchill and I decided to bury him in my parents' garden because they've got a nice big garden and that way I'd be able to visit him as often as I wanted. The only problem was that my parents live a long way from me. They live on the other side of London. So to get to my parents' house, I had to make a long journey by tube. So I put Churchill in my suitcase. I wrapped him up and I set off on my journey. And I got to the underground and I bought my ticket and I started my journey. When I got to the other end, the escalator wasn't working, so I had to walk up the stairs. But my suitcase was very heavy and I had a lot of other things. My handbag, my magazine, and the tube was very crowded. There were a lot of people. It was a rush hour, and the whole thing was becoming very uncomfortable. When suddenly a man, a complete stranger, came up to me and asked if I needed any help. Well, that was wonderful. I thought, what a gentleman, how kind. And I gave him my suitcase, and we started walking up the stairs. But he walked very, very quickly, much more quickly than I could walk up the stairs. In fact, he was going up two at a time, almost running, and I almost lost sight of him. In fact, by the time I got to the top of the stairs, I'd lost him completely. He was nowhere to be seen. Now, that's the rather sad bit, because I thought the man was being kind, but in fact, he was a thief. He'd stolen my suitcase. He wasn't being kind at all. Mind you, I'd love to have seen the look on his face when he opened the suitcase and saw inside.
How I stopped smoking. I started smoking when I was 16. I didn't really want to smoke, but at that age, it's important to imitate your friends. Once I had started, of course, it was hard to stop. And smoking gave me something to do with my hands. Whenever I met strangers, I couldn't help reaching for a cigarette to give me confidence, to make me look cool and sophisticated. Soon I couldn't go through a day without smoking 20 to 30 cigarettes. But smoking made me feel ill and smell bad, and I was tired of feeling ill and smelling bad. And I realized that it was stupid to spend so much money on a ridiculous habit. So I tried to stop. Hundreds of times, I always kept on giving up. I became an expert on giving up smoking. Nothing worked. I always started again. At least I had a piece of luck. I got terrible bronchitis, so bad that I simply couldn't smoke. It lasted for months. And when I finally recovered, I realized that I had broken the habit. And I didn't have to start smoking again. And I never did.